Greetings, hello, and welcome back. Thank you very much for tuning in. I'm Imperial Jedi. This is episode number 3 coming at you, and a very fun one on the dock for today. We're actually going to be building 2 different interchanges, both of which are actually pretty suitable as a replacement for your starting interchange. Had some requests on what we can do for upgrades for that. So today we'll build 2 interchanges. We'll build a partial cloverleaf as well as a trumpet style interchange. Episode 4, we're going to build another 2 interchanges, and that means what we'll do is we'll push back the traffic testing as well as the modded improvements and the vanilla improvements. We'll do all that in episode 5. So 3, 4, and 5, longer episodes. We'll try and jam more content into it. Hopefully you guys don't mind. And when we come back and do another mini-series again a little bit later on public transit, I will have a much better feel and format. I won't be all over the place. But yeah, it's only because you guys are enjoying this more than I had originally thought, which is definitely not a bad thing. Okay, enough chit-chat. Let's do some building here. So you might notice that the city layout is just a little bit different. So if you actually wanted to build right alongside, take a look in the description. I've got 2 different links you can download. The first one is for how the city looks with these slight improvements between last episode and this one. So we've got a little bit of an extension here to the 6-lane road, trying to incorporate the train there as well. And I've extended just this highway slightly, built a bridge, and I realigned this one and made a little bit more of a plateau here. And this is just for episode 4's sake. So the first link is how the city looks right now. The second link is going to be the city at the end of the episode. And I'm also going to be including the 81 tile mod, just in case. So I'll kind of tell you why. In vanilla, you're allowed to have 9 tiles total. If you'll look right now, we've got a total of 12, so we're kind of breaking those rules already. I downloaded the 81 tile mod to be able to do that. And just as far as the test goes, I only bought 12 tiles. I turned the mod off, and then when I loaded the map back up without the mod on, I still have access to the 12 tiles. So I think you guys are okay to download this without the 81 tiles, but just in case, so I'll throw the link in there. And then I just picked the 4x4 because it gives us access to like all the interchanges and just a little bit more room to stretch our legs. Okay, let's build, shall we? So if you are not going to be building on the same map, the first thing you're going to want to do is just run 2 roads next to each other, and this is just going to be our highway, right? And in this case, we're using the streets here instead of the highway, because we want the zoning squares. That helps with our planning and layout. All right, so once you have this down, or if you're using this particular map here, next thing you're going to do is you're going to place down a collector system. And don't worry about like the length or whatever. That's totally not the important part. The main thing is you want it just to be 1 tile apart from your express lanes here. So these 2 have to be 2 tiles apart. That one just 1 tile apart. See in between? 2 and 1? That's the key to it. Now, if we are going to be lining up with a pre-existing road, we're going to want to get that nice and close. Just for the sake of this, I'm actually going to turn the road guidelines off. But we're going to just, make sure we're lined up. We're going to be 2 tiles apart, like we've done in the past. And we're just going to go up and over as a bridge. And this is just a personal preference thing, but I find that the 6-lane road looks better when you're at a height of 12 meters for your bridge. You can still do a 9-meter height, but I just feel like it just makes it, the spacing is just so tight here. It seems like the trucks are going to clip or something. I don't know. So just added realism. I like that. But to each their own. Okay, so let's back that 6-lane road up. We don't want anything in our way. So we should basically be looking like this. We've got our express lane. That's a 2-tile spacing. We've got the collector. It's a 1-tile spacing. And we just got, the 6-lane road over top. And the main thing is we've got the pillar in the middle and the pillar on each side, and it's 2 tiles apart. Fantastic. Now, just like the last build, like the unit count is pretty important here, so let's gotta make sure we follow everything along. Okay, so we know from experience that if we use a length of 12 units to get down, that will be the smoothest slope. So let's go down by 12, and let's go out by 10. And then once that 10 is down, we're going to go out by another 10 again. So, nice and slow. So we're counting up by 12, just going down at ground level. In this case, we're remembering that we're the extra click up. We don't want to be at a height of 3, just right down at ground level. Right, double check. And then out by 10, out by 10 again. Now, the key to this is to have even spaced nodes. If for whatever bizarre reason, maybe you built it in sections or just something happened along the way, if you end up with too many nodes, or if they're not spaced properly, you really gotta, this is a bad thing. So just delete them, no problem, and just back it on up and start again. So there's 10 more, totally no problem. See, that fixes the spacing here, easy peasy. Alright, so as long as we look like this, we are A-okay. Next thing we want to do is switch on over to our one-way road again. And we're going to find that middle node. And in this case, we're going to kind of leave with traffic, if that makes any weird sense. So we're going to click on the middle node, straight road, and we're going out to the 10-unit mark, which in this case is 400 credits. So that's out by 10, which is 400 credits, and then out by 10 again, which is 400 credits. So just very easy to remember. 10, 10, 10, and 10. Super, super easy. And then the other side, same idea. We're going to click on the middle pillar, and just think of it as like going with the direction of traffic. So we're just going out like that. But don't worry about what direction everything's going. We're going to fix everything at the end, and we'll talk about why, you know, why they're going that way and everything. Okay, now, next step we want to do is connect basically these on up. And you can see just right now, we can't do it in a straight line. So we're going to switch over to our curvy tool, or sorry, our freeform. We're going to click on the top right here for anchoring. We're going to pick either the left side or the right side, doesn't matter which one first. We're going to anchor again just at the top of that little zoning area. And then we'll just bring that down and connect on up. And this is fairly important because we're going to end up with a really cool kind of like road guideline thing as an end result here. So same thing again, right? So we're going to anchor here. We're going to anchor over there. And we're just going to bring this on down. So you should basically end up with like a little triangle pyramid thing, like a sailboat sail, I guess. So let's do the same thing on the other side, just for simplicity. So again, just clicking on here for the anchor, clicking on there for the second anchor point, and then bring it on down. And just to recap, like a straight line won't work. If you do too wide of a curve, it'll look unattractive. It's just not what we're after. So clicking here and going down. Cool. So this is what we're supposed to be looking like. Fantastic. Now, this is where things get a little bit crazy, and I'll kind of explain my logic for this. If you happen to have the mass transit DLC, use the asymmetrical road, but because not everyone's going to have this, I'm going to use a two-lane road here. If you don't like the look of the two-lane road, you don't mind it being a bit wider, you can also use a four-lane. So that's why things are a little bit crazy, but just for this example's sake, I'm going to use a two-lane road, but if you got it, I highly recommend the asymmetrical. All right, so this is where things get crazy, but just follow along, not too hard. So we've got our freeform road on. We're on the two-way traffic, right? We're going to click here to anchor. We're going to go just outside our bubble. We're going to anchor again. Now you see the road guidelines that are popping in? There's the one here, there's the one over there, and there's the one to the right. We want that one. We gotta make sure we're not getting confused with the one from the highway. That's not what we're after. So just the one coming out from here. Just nice and slow, we'll find it. There it is. Perfect. So don't get that one, just that one right there. And if this is getting in your way, there's no problem if you want to just move that over just a little bit. Because we've already got our bridge spacing. We already know that part, right? We can redo these later. So again, we're just clicking up here, anchoring just outside the bubble, and just following that, and there it is right there. Perfect. But we're not getting distracted by that one. Okay, let's do the same thing on this side. So anchor up and over, fantastic. Cool. Okay, so we should be left with this. Bit of an odd shape, but we're slowly getting there. Okay, next thing we're gonna do is switch back over to our one-way road. We're gonna go to our straight road, and we're gonna find that middle connection again. We're gonna move on over, and we're going to be a distance of one tile, and we're going to draw a nice straight line right to the edge of the tiles here. So not to the outside, but just right to the edge. So just be left with that. So we're lining up these two, right? Nice and 90. And that should just be, 200 credits worth of space apart. So let's do the same thing on the other side. So we'll just zoom in this other side of the triangle, just move on over, find that one tile spacing, come on up like this. And then we're going right to the edge of the tiles. And let's say, for example, you go too far in, no problem. We can just draw that back. It's right there to the edge of the tile. Get rid of that part. Double check the spacing. That's 200 credits distance. That's 200 credits distance. Easy peasy. Lots of ways to double check, right? It's one of those, like, measure twice, cut once. A lot easier, that approach. Okay, let's connect these now to our collector lane. So we'll switch over to the freeform. Not a lot of room to do a bend in here, so maybe we'll kind of pick one that looks nice. That one doesn't work. that's kind of a 45. I don't think the road will look all that nice. There's a little bit of a bend. That's the bend I'm after. So just, you know, play around. See which one you like. All I've done is just gone up a little bit, anchored again, and I've gone to the point where it won't work, then I back it up by one. You can see there's a little bit too sharp of a turn. Getting better. That's the best. Doesn't really matter which one you choose. The main thing is that it looks nicer when they're even. And just a little gentle curve here. That's good. Okay, if we want to, we can start making our collector a little bit more lined up and pretty. So let's get rid of the extra roads now on both sides of that little curvy bit. And just a bit of an asterisk, this is going to present a unique challenge here. So I'll show you another way you can connect up to the highway, but we'll worry about that in a second. Okay, so over here, let's do the easy side first. We'll go out by 10, and we'll go out by another 10. And it's just easy for us to remember that way. So that's 800 credits. We can do 800 credits we want over here. Same idea. Nice even node spacing. Perfect. And then what we can do is just a very simple, we'll just bring this in. Now in this case, we're gonna just connect right up to where that bridge pillar is. But for this side, I'll show you how to get the spacing right. So remember our little curvy road here? It's on the right angle so that we can just go in a straight line now. So if I switch to our one-way road and just follow that in a straight line, see how it bubbles a little bit. I think we lost 1 degree there, but close enough that's totally fine. So we'll go a nice straight line. And this one, we're going to try and line these up. So we'll go across at the 90. Remember, we're already 20 units out, so we're close enough now that when we get over, we'll see the road guideline pop in. So switching over to our freeform road, we're going to anchor once here, go out about 45 or so, anchor again, and then as we start to curve, see how we can kind of line ourselves up? I don't want to go too far. See how it bubbles a little bit? Just want to be just far enough. And then when I switch over to my straight road tool, so I right click to get off that, but see how it's almost straight. Might be off by a hint, but that really is no problem. So we'll get rid of that. And if you want to, I mean, you can change the direction now, but getting there, eh? All right. This is where we should be at. And then just, like on this side, you can see the bridge kind of presents a little bit of an issue. I could, if I wanted to, connect to that bridge. I don't think that looks all that nice, though, personally. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go a little bit straight. Just a hint. And then I'm going to kind of freeform this. Why don't we just curve a little bit and then try and curve again right there. And what we're aiming for is nothing that's too sharp. Because if it's too sharp, traffic's got to really slow down. And same with our steep, you know, for the slopes, right? If that's too steep, traffic's really got to slow down for it. So this might maybe take you a little bit of play until you're kind of happy with it. You can always do a fun combination of some crazy things. Like if you're feeling up for the challenge, and you can always look on Google Maps for this, but you can try doing like a little corkscrew. Or maybe have, you know, the lane kind of exit a little bit beforehand, curve on around like that type thing. Yeah, so don't be afraid to be creative. And if you find that like this is in the way, just get rid of it. We don't need it just yet. Okay, so let's bring this in. And that, yeah, I think that's fine for me. Cool. Okay, so let's now deal with the other side of our collector lane. And again, things are a little crazy, but if you follow along, totally no problem here. So we're going to make sure we're on our one-way road. We're going to zoom on in, and we're just going to go right under the bridge, right to the edge of that tile. And all we need is just a little road here. And that introduces the new node, so when I delete, it deletes right to that point. And we'll get rid of that now. So, perfect. So same thing on the other side. If we need to, extend that to give us a little more room. The direction going the same way. We'll make it so that's one, like one node piece, essentially. We're gonna go right to the edge of the tiles again, and just draw a little bit out, and we'll delete the extra. That's perfect. Okay, so that little node piece right there, we're going to click on that when we have our freeform road tool selected. We're going to click on this. We're going to anchor over to where about that drops down. So about here or so. And then we're just going to come on in. And that's us right there. Perfect. Do the same thing on the other side. All right, so we got that anchor point right there. We're going to go on over, and we're looking for what is kind of the point that matches with that. So clicking on over here, and we got the freeform, and we're gonna come on in like that, and does a nice smooth curvy for us. So this is kind of more or less where we should be at. So we're just about to, we're in the final bend here, 11th hour, so we're almost done this. Okay, next thing we're gonna do is just extend the six lane road just a little bit. Make a little bit more semblance of that. And then we'll connect this side up to that intersection point right there. So freeform, one-way road, anchoring here, going a few tiles down, and then just bring it on in. Easy peasy. Same thing on the other side. And now, at this point, we can go over and get all the lines going the right way. So what we've essentially done is we've made ourselves an interchange where you can get on and off the highway without really having to cross in front of too much traffic. And whenever you do, you'll have the safety of the light to kind of protect you. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. So if you're coming from this way, and if you wanted to get onto the highway and end up to the right, you would take this road right here. So let's get those directions going the right way. And we actually don't need a traffic light here right now. So let's take that out. So no traffic light there. We need a traffic light right here. No traffic light there. So let's do the same thing on the other side. So no, yes, and no. That's what we should be left with. And then this is a way out. That's a way in. That's a way out. So this is how your road network should look. That's your collector arm going in. Let's get that all right. Okay, so let's talk about this again here, now that everything's going the right way. So if you're coming from this way, and let's say hypothetically this traffic light is red, a little bit of a backup here, you can still get onto the highway and, you know, just scoot around the light, no problem. So a little bit of a continuous flow kind of style happening here. And then same principle idea here, because there's no traffic light, when you're leaving the highway turning right, you just enter traffic and off you go. So a lot of flow through for this style of interchange. Anyway, so you're coming this way, you turn right, that's you get on the highway. If you wanted to go on the highway the other way, you would go up and over, you would cross the bridge, you would not come down here and turn left though. Instead, what you do is you would turn right. You can see there's no traffic light here, so you don't have to wait for anyone. If this light is red, you can still get onto the highway. You turn right. When you get to this intersection, you turn right, and then you can see here, turn right again. And that's you on the collector that brings you in. The collector merges with the express. Off you go. Now, what we've done here is, yeah, we've created a way on the highway for both sides without having to cross in front of any traffic. When you're leaving the highway, this is you exiting the highway, right? Go through here. If you're going to be turning left, you go straight. If you're gonna be turning right, you'll go this way. In vanilla, you can see we don't have too much choice because the lane arrows are presenting both sides still. That's okay. So we'll end up with one lane being used. People should not turn right because this is the faster way to go right. AI should recognize that. In some instances though, maybe traffic's coming down and turning this way. An approach to fixing that would be maybe try upgrading some of these partially to a highway. So a little bit of play with that. Yeah, you can see principally it's a very smart design. It's actually not a new style of interchange. It's I think it was made in the late 70s, and it's a Canadian invention. It actually comes from the province of Ontario, so the Ministry of Transportation for Ontario came up with this, and it's very, very common in North America. And a way to make this a little bit more faster flow through is hypothetically make these into roundabouts, so connect it all up the roundabout. But yeah, this is it. Partial cloverleaf, really awesome. And then just for some added help with the lane changes, I think having these two as avenues and then the rest as a six laner is a really good approach. It's that same idea to try and get dedicated turning lanes. So I like that a lot. And don't be afraid to maybe try, you see right here, that's a two laner. Maybe shrink that down, see that dedicated turning lane. So just little combinations like that. But we're gonna go over all this in episode 5. Well, there we go. That's the first of our two interchanges done. Hopefully this will be helpful for someone out there. And yeah, kind of fun having the bridge. Otherwise, you would have made it very uniform. And of course, you know, the more of these you build, the more comfortable you'll get making them. You can make them a lot smaller. If you're okay using some mods, you can make them like way, way smaller than this. But just get you started. I think this is really awesome. Good shape. Looking pretty good too. Okay, so let's head over and let's build ourselves a trumpet style interchange now. Now, for this one, like more often than not, we're connected to the city, we've been relying on this, like it's our city link. So you're gonna wanna make sure you have I want to say around maybe 75,000 to 100,000 credits, just so you have like a very big safety net. Because if things go horribly wrong and you can't afford to reconnect your highway, your city will literally fall apart. So you just got to be very, very cautious. And on the same flip of that coin, I would very, very highly recommend that your game is on pause. Because let's say, for example, we sever our main highway connection. If your only power plant is reliant on coal coming in from the network, and you know the coal truck can't get into your city, well, that's a recipe for disaster. Okay, so we're left with this. It's kind of a little bit of a stir. In this particular instance, we're going to need a collector lane on the outside. So we'll just go ahead and draw that. And the same idea as before, it doesn't really matter how long it is. We want it kind of in line with this, so we know where the bridge pillars need to be. And I already know ahead of time that this highway is not perfectly in line with this, so it's going to be just a little bit crooked, but that's okay. Now, we're going to use some tricks from our previous episode. So if we close this over, we get our zoning squares here. If we elevate to the 3 meter height, we can get these two pillars to be right next to each other. And that'll make for a really clean looking trumpet. So this is familiar, we know what we're doing here. And I would otherwise use this as my point for reference, but I'd like it to be possibly in line with this. Or you know what actually we could do? Let's back that up. And we'll change that. Let's go off of this for symmetry right now. Okay, so we'll do our best. Now these ones are gonna be a height of 9 meters. And I would say that's pretty darn close right there. So we can just kind of visually line this up. I think I want to be one tile down. That's pretty darn close enough, yeah. Okay, so I'm a big fan of having the two tile spacing. In this case, we're gonna have to build the bridge in a couple segments, which is totally no problem. And I feel like this kind of ties a little bit into realism. So when your pillars are far away from the highway, just like they would be in real life, if there's an accident, which there wouldn't be in Skylines, but just for that realism, if there's an accident, you don't want like cars to hit this, right? Cars going highway speed, if they get pushed off the road and hit this, I mean, that's just a very dangerous collision. So space these out. That's why they have like the guide rails around them, sometimes the water barrels. So if you hit it, you're getting pushed out of the way. So we want good spacing here, just for that added realism. And if we are elevated, we can have our roads be right next to each other. And you saw before we had to draw this in two segments, which is no problem at all. Let's just do that again. And you can see it just gets rid of that middle pillar, which is kind of cool. So these two being next to each other, A-okay, is what we're after. Now this is where things get kind of fun. So I'm going to draw two roads that are parallel to each other, and I'll show you guys a fun trick for that. So we've got our collector arm in, we've got our bridge arm over top. We're going to click on here, we're going to go out by 10, and we're going to go out by another 10. And in this case, we're going to drop down to a height of 3 meters. So we're going from 9 down to 3. Now if I do the same thing over here, if I go 10 to 10, see that just doesn't, like, what the heck have we done here, right? But if we use a little bit of math, so that's 1, that's 2. So 10 plus 2 is 12. So there's 11. Let's turn off our road guidelines, make this easier. There's 10, 11, 12. Then what happens if I go, there's 10, 11, 12, down to 3. What are we left with? A perfectly parallel road. The pillars are in the exact same spot, and it follows, look at that, the curve profile perfectly. And if we wanted to, we could use this as an approach to kind of making our roads like narrow and wide again. So hypothetically, if I wanted to maybe keep that 2-unit spacing, instead of being 12 by 12, we would have done a 10 by 10 and then a 14 by 14. And that would make the road go wide. That's kind of a fun way to make your roads go in and out. Okay, so we're left with this. It's looking pretty darn cool. If we were to now do another 10 by 10, I don't think we're going to have enough room to get that little gentle curve. So instead, let's back it up. Let's do an 8 by 8. So there's 10, there's 9, there's 8. It's the same idea. There's the 10. We'll back it up. There's 9, there's 8. And let's bring this one down to ground level here. And we're just going to switch over to our curvy road, or so the freeform. Just click once here, and we're just going to find that right little bend. I think that's it right there. Just a little gentle curve in. You can change the direction, kind of an idea of where things are going now. And then we'll do the other side. So in this case, you know, 8 by 8, we're going to add the 2, so that makes 10 by 10. And we know from experience that we can't get down to ground level, because the two of them will be too close together. So one will stay elevated, which is no problem. And then we're going to bring this over, and we're going to just connect on up. And that we're just going to eyeball, just do our best for that. And then same with this. We're just going to kind of do our best. Because the road is starting to curve, it's going to be a little bit challenging. So I might actually do this in two steps here. Try that again. Oh yeah, that's better. That's principally what I'm after. Just kind of that same little gentle curve right there. A little bit of a downhill. Perfect. Looks very nice. Okay, so now we got to connect this up to the old highway and then do the other side. But so far, so good. I like this a lot. Okay, so we can connect this on up if we want. And again, just a little bit of trial and error until we get the shape and curve and everything that we're after. Sometimes the terrain does play an effect. And I'll show you guys after some stuff, you know. You'll notice what I'll show you it after. But if you're getting a whole bunch of weird lane changes, I'll give you guys a quick little bit of tips for that. Okay, so let's bring these down. So let's go down to ground level. Now we know from experience, right, that we can't go straight with this. We're gonna have to gently, just ever so gently, curve outwards. So we're gonna try and meet up with this. Let's go in a nice curve to start. I think that actually might be enough room to get in. Nope. Okay, so in this case, what we could do is maybe go a little bit further down. Or we can just do our best to try and eyeball. Actually, that's not too bad at all. Just for a little bit of an eyeball there. Not too shabby. Maybe some trial and errors is necessary for that, though. And again, if we wanted to keep the bridges in a straight line, they'd have to be at a height of 3. But that's a nice little gentle way to go wide there. I'm okay with that. Okay. Put those the right way. So you see right here, I can't upgrade the road. That's totally no problem. All we gotta do is just delete it and draw it again in the direction that we want to go. That sometimes happens. So remember from before, we have to do it in two steps. That gets rid of the middle pillar. Oh, it added this time. Interesting. Can we add it over here? No. So what happened here, it looks like we were off by one tile. And that's because of the direction. Well, that's totally fine, though. That's totally not a problem. Okay, let's worry about the other side of the connection now. So we're going to try our best to try to be, you know, at the 90. So it's about right there. Draw this out. If we have some problems like we do right now, we can just do what we did and draw the kind of collector lane, I guess you can call it, first. And I'll put that about there. And we're going to try for a nice, smooth, oh yeah, angle going to that one. That's nice. And again, if it's a little bit too sharp, then people are going to have to slow down too much and you create a bit of a bottleneck point. But I'm happy with that. Let's now curve that in. In this case, it looks like maybe the nodes aren't really cooperating with us, so let's try deleting that, and we'll redraw it as one long segment, and that might maybe be the cure for the node problem there. Nope, still the same thing, that's okay. Let's go nice and slow. Perfect. Pretty darn close enough. And then, again, just remember, draw your segments again as one long one, and that'll help with the spacing and the nodes and little smoothness problems. Excellent, I like that. Let's try and do the same thing over here. Just bring that in. Great. And so, I'm gonna press 3-speed now so we can watch traffic really quickly. So you can see some very bizarre lane changes happening, right? You see people going from lane 3 to lane 1, I guess, technically. That, it just creates a bottleneck. You guys have seen this. Very, very bad for the highways. So a couple ways you can combat this is just like we did before. It's better when you're on pause. Delete the roads, put them back in. That'll help with the spacing of your nodes. Helps reset that. The nodes are where your cars are gonna possibly do a recalculation and a lane change. So whenever a car goes over a node, just checks with your CPU, do I need to do anything? If not, it'll keep on going straight. So if these are well spaced out, your lane changing doesn't look as awkward. So we can already see smoother lane changing here. There's still a little bit of a slowdown happening, so I don't think this is the perfect solution. So what we could do now is maybe upgrade this to be a 4-lane road. right? So we end up with a dedicated turning lane plus a secondary turning lane. I'd say traffic's a little bit better. We still have a lot of people cutting over, though. So I'd say this is not the best approach. Instead, what we're going to do is switch back to the three-lane road, and we'll make this a one-lane exit. So we're ending up here with a dedicated straight and turning lane. So that'll help traffic a little bit. And when it comes to vanilla, it's very challenging to get multi-lane usage out of this kind of stuff. So I'll show you in episode 5 when we do some updates with mods, how you can kind of sneak some extra lane usage out. But hypothetically, if we wanted to get both of these lanes used, we'd have to find a way for both of these to end up turning inward. Because this is only just like an in and out for the collector, no one's going to stick to that lane. They'll stick to this because it's faster, right? So in this setup, we might not see two lanes being used here. However, on this side, if I do an upgrade, that'll fix our problem down over here, right? We have the one lane exiting, but over here, we actually might see two lane usage. And the reason for that is these both will enter this. Down here, we have an eventual break in traffic. So people that would be exiting and going to the right very likely might take the outside right lane the whole way. And then anyone not using this, maybe sticking to the express lanes, might stick to the left. We'll have a higher likelihood of that if way down here, we have the option to keep going left. So it's very strange how AI traffic works, but we're gonna follow some cards, go over all this in episode 5. But be a little bit creative when you're upgrading and changing stuff around. But I think that's it, guys. I think I will leave you here. So very functional, very fun. Visually looks a lot better than what we had before. And just these little turning arms here look like the bottom piece of an actual trumpet, which is kind of where the name comes from. And same with the partial cloverleaf. As you get really comfortable and make more of these, you can make them a lot tighter, a lot smaller, visually maybe look a little bit better. You can start with the detailing, but this is just to kind of get you started. So my friends, I will see you in the next episode. Like I said, if you want to download the city as it is, download link number 2. Otherwise, the first one was just before we did our construction. And I will see you guys in the next one. And next episode, we're going to build the other version of this thing. So partial cloverleaf, but we're going to do a highway to highway. And we're going to extend this over, build that over here just for fun. And we're then going to extend this over and we're going to build a different style. So we'll do a double crossover merging interchange, which is kind of the fancy highway version of the DDI. So this is being governed by a traffic light at ground level. With the double crossover merging interchange, instead of a traffic light, we'll have overlapping bridges. So it'll be like really, really cool. And that'll be like the last big interchange we'll build. So we'll end on a bang. And yeah, I'll see you guys again for episode 5 for our implementing of our little city and our traffic testing, plus the mods and the vanilla improvements. And again, feel free to just ask any questions and stuff. I'll make everything available to be downloaded using as little mods as possible. And as a little DLC as possible, sorry. And we'll come back in a little bit once the city is built, and we'll have another mini-series on public transit. Otherwise, that's it, guys. I will see you in episode 4. Thanks for watching. Happy building. And don't forget that we have a Discord. You can share some screenshots and let us know what you're doing. All right, guys. See you in the next episode. Happy building. Have a great day.